Hello and welcome to this channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can install any mod for Assetto Corsa, as well as how to properly install the Content Manager, the Custom Shaders patch, and the Sol Weather mod. So first of all, you want to visit this website and scroll down a bit and hit the download button. This will copy a zipped version of the Content Manager to your PC. Next, you obviously want to unzip this file, whereas the location you put the Content Manager doesn't really matter, like anything works here. But for simplicity's sake, I'm just going to place it on my desktop here. Now just open the Content Manager by double clicking it, and this little window here will open. Normally, the Content Manager should be able to automatically detect your Assetto Corsa installation location as well as your Steam ID. If for whatever reason the Content Manager fails to do so, I'll leave a link in the description where you can find your Steam ID for yourself and quickly demonstrate how you can locate your Assetto Corsa root folder. To do so, just go to your Steam library, select Assetto Corsa, right-click, hover over Manage, and select Browse Local Files. Then you can simply copy the path displayed by your Windows Explorer at the very top and paste it into the according field in the Content Manager. Afterwards, just simply press OK and you have successfully installed the Content Manager. Now, our next point of focus is to correctly install the Custom Shaders patch for Assetto Corsa. And this is how you do it. Go to the top right of the Content Manager, select Settings, and then go to the top left and choose the option Custom Shaders patch. Simply press Install, and if it says there are missing configs and asks you to reinstall them, just press Yes, please. As you can see on the right hand side of your screen, there are a lot of available versions for the Custom Shaders patch, but I'd always recommend you to use the latest version that is marked in green and labeled as recommended, as all other versions may be unstable. Generally speaking, the Custom Shaders patch should work just fine now, but I'd advise you to locate the Lighting FX section on the left and turn down the overall brightness to 100 to 150%. So yeah, that's it for the Custom Shaders patch. Now let's move on to the Sol Weather mod. Just go ahead to this website, hit download, and when your download is finished, just open the zipped file. Then you have to go down a few folders, just open mods here, then open the according Sol folder, and finally, select everything in there and copy it to a Assetto Corsa root folder. If any of those files are already present there, then just let Windows overwrite them. If you have done everything correctly and open up your Content Manager again, go to the location where you previously selected the Custom Shaders patch and then select the Apps category right next to the right side of it. There should now be three Sol specific apps. Just make sure here that under Sol Config, the Sol Config checkbox is actually ticked, as this option allows you to configure the in-game weather in Assetto Corsa on the fly. Now, there's only one last thing for you to validate. Just head over to the Assetto Corsa section under Settings, right to the left of the Custom Shaders patch, go to the Video section, and select Sol as your filter under the Post-Processing effects. And with this also completed, you have successfully installed Sol's Weather mod for Assetto Corsa. Now, as a small bonus at the end, I thought I'd also quickly show you how you can utilize the Content Manager to actually install any mod you wish. In this case, my specimen is the 2017 version of Le Mans, which I'm now going to download onto my PC and then install it with the help of my Content Manager. And trust me, it's pretty easy. Just wait until your download has finished, select the according zip file and drag the zip file into your Content Manager. Then the three highlighted bars in the top right should light up green, which means your Content Manager is preparing to install your selected mod. And if you click on those three bars and the preparation process has finished, there should be the option to install your mod at the very bottom. Now, obviously, you want to press install, and now you just have to wait until the red horizontal bar is finished, and then you should be able to select your installed mod. In my case, I should be able to select the 2017 Le Mans circuit as a track. So yeah, that was it for this guide. If you did enjoy this video, or hopefully could get something useful out of it, you could also consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers, guys.